Hi guys, welcome to a video, and in today's video I'm just going to be reviewing the film Torv. I apologise if I'm not pronouncing her name correctly. It is because I have 1.5 brain cells who are currently threatening to go on strike. Yes, this film is my most anticipated lesbian film release of this year. I was so excited to watch this film because I am a fan of the Moomins, a big fan. I have loved them since I was a very small child, and I even have a Moomin tattoo. I am an adult, I promise. I've read some of Torv's novels and I also find her incredibly interesting. You know, this film, it has Moomins, it has lesbians, it has boobs, and that is why I spent money on it. So if you're not familiar with what this film is about, it is about the bohemian life of artist and writer Torv Jansson. And the film explores her early years as a struggling artist in Helsinki, where she is generally shunned by the artistic establishment. Eventually, she meets a married theatre director called Vivica Bandler, and the two start up, you know, a pretty steamy love affair. This is directly linked to Torv's creative endeavours, and the film follows the success of her work. So the film is basically a celebration about the life and the work of this woman. Honestly, I love this film. It is so beautiful and strange and haunting, which encapsulates Torv Jansson and her work so completely. If you are a fan of the Moomins, I can absolutely recommend this film because it shows you just how many layers there are to their creation. It has gay undertones. It does. Oh, it does. And even if you're not a fan of the Moomins, it's a fascinating look at women's history and also lesbian history. So there is really a lot going on in this film. I nearly shouted out loud when I saw her drawing Snufkin on screen. I did. I'm that much of a fangirl. The film is beautifully shot and beautifully crafted. I don't know what equipment they were using, but I felt like I was literally watching a vintage piece. It's incredibly beautiful. And there are some fantastic directing choices by Zaida Bergroth, the director. She has just done a phenomenal job on this film. Casting is incredible, the acting was incredible, and the film says so much without really saying much at all. The relationship between Torv and Vivica was very complex and interesting. Both actors gave such a raw performance, which was just captivating to watch, and it's fascinating to see how Torv's personal life bled into her work in that way. I loved the part about how they had their own language and how that was mirrored through the characters in the book. It really is such an intimate and raw piece. On a personal note, I really love post-war aesthetic and fashion, so that was a huge plus in this film. I very much enjoyed the costume, and I cried at the end of this film. I did, I cried. I don't have any dislikes or criticisms at all for this film. It really is. It's an immaculate, gorgeous piece of cinema. The only thing I will say is it may not be for people with shorter attention spans because the film is quite drawn out and, you know, the pacing is quite slow. Now, I don't mind this, but I know some people prefer a little bit of action. This film is not Die Hard. You know, this film is very much about the details and the emotional cues and the kind of undertones running through the piece. It's really, really good. I really enjoyed it, and it's just refreshing to review a film where so much love and care has been poured into it. And so congratulations to the cast and the crew and everybody who made this film possible. It really is a beautiful, beautiful piece of work. It really is fantastic. Okay guys, if you've seen the film, let me know what you thought of it in the comments. If you haven't seen it, I can definitely recommend that you go and see it, you know, especially if you're a fan of the Moomins like myself. Don't forget to subscribe for instant disappointment, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.